teman-teman semua, terima kasih sudah datang di rumah Iva. Sore ini kita punya tamu dari Cina, namanya Casey Wu Zhang. Beliau adalah kurator dan seniman dan kritikus. Dan sore ini kita akan dengerin Usmat, mungkin artis top jadinya ya, artis top dari Casey. Kemudian Casey akan berbicara dalam bahasa Cina, tapi ada Mbak Margaret yang akan menerjemahkan ke bahasa Inggris. Jadi diskusinya, artis topnya akan berlangsung dalam bahasa Inggris, tapi nanti kalau ada dan kita akan dimoderatori oleh Sita di sini. Jadi kalau ada teman-teman yang mau tanya nanti bisa dalam bahasa Indonesia juga bisa, atau langsung bahasa Inggris. Kalau bahasa Indonesia nanti akan dibantu oleh Sita untuk diterjemahkan ke bahasa Inggris. Kemudian Mbak Margaret akan menerjemahkan ke bahasa Cina. Jadi lintas bahasa. Langsung aja ya, saya serahkan ke Sita, silahkan.
Berasal dari Cina dan dikenal sebagai seniman, juga kurator dan kritikus seni rupa. Casey banyak berkarya dengan berbagai medium, lukisan, performance, juga instalasi. Beberapa di antaranya dalam medium-medium tersebut. Dan saat ini Casey sedang berada di Jogja, itu dalam rangka berkarya dan sedang melakukan residensi independen, residensi mandiri. Yang bekerja sama dengan Jogja Independent Residency dan nantinya akan berpameran di Local Art Foundation pada tanggal 16 September 2015. Jadi di talk ini juga kami mengundang teman-teman yang hadir untuk datang ke pameran pada tanggal 16 nanti. Dan seperti yang sudah digambarkan tadi juga, artis talk akan berlangsung dalam bahasa. Dan Casey akan mulai menjelaskan pada kesempatan kali ini. Casey akan menjelaskan praktik dia yang sudah baik sebagai seniman juga sebagai kurator. Untuk mempersingkat waktu, langsung saja saya berikan kepada Casey dan nanti Margaret yang akan mengalih bahasakan ke bahasa Inggris.
Sebenarnya 各位艺术家还有有关来替我讲的朋友们，问好啊！我呢主要是先讲那个大的讲的我的哪个能力啊，就是。So good afternoon, everybody.
Very happy to be in Jogja. So now he said he will introduce himself to the artist friend here.
我呢，主要是最开始在中国的时候呢，是在匹兹，在美术出版社工作。后来呢，就是说那个受西方的那个游牧主义影响，就是在92年的时候，我就出国了，去了做游牧艺术。之后呢，我就因为那个东南亚、泰国一个机会来青岛做展览，我就来到东南亚参观，我们深圳这边。
He graduated from the university with a Chinese painting, majored in Chinese painting. But in 1980s, he worked for the government-based art publishing house as a chief director, a chief editor. But 1991, he went to Russia, Soviet Union, was a visiting scholar invited by the Ministry of Culture of Soviet Union. So he stayed in the Soviet Union and Russia in Moscow for 2 years. After that, he traveled in Eastern Europe to have an exhibition and became an independent artist. Then he was invited by the foundation in Thailand. So he came to Thailand in Southeast Asia because it's closer than in Russia to the motherland. And then he stayed in Thailand, lived in Thailand for more than 20 years.
在那个泰国呢，我主要是做一些，同时呢跟朋友一起呢做
Actually, he's an artist, but in Thailand, for an independent artist, it's very difficult. So he's opened his own space, art gallery, commercial art gallery, and on the other hand, he cooperated with some friends to start an art magazine, a fine art magazine in Thailand, both in Thai and some in Chinese, in Thai and English language. Later, because he has a lot of a relationship with Thai artist and in Chinese artist, so the Silakopan University, we have a friend, he's a professor in Silakopan University, a very famous art university in Southeast Asia. So he asked us to cooperate with them to do some exchange program between China and Southeast Asia. So that's why we set up ASEAN plus China, 10 plus 1 art category. Because 10 is means in Southeast Asia, ASEAN, they have 10 countries, and plus 1 is China. Since 2008, we think, 2008 or 2009, there are free zone from China to between China and Southeast Asia. So, but the free zone is economy free zone. But nobody do the art and culture program between China and Southeast Asia. So we set up the program project. So depends on the fund. If we have more funds, so we will do the bigger event. So we start in 2008. But before we do some, we had do some exhibitions between China and Southeast Asia. So since 2006.
2010年呢，我就回中国比较多了，中间呢，我在上海，那么就是跟朋友们那个在一起聊天，在私底下跟朋友聊天，说我们做一个展览啊，这个展览就是跟亚洲旅游的事业性的，正好呢是2010年2016年呢有一个上海双年展，在这种双年展，我们做外围展怎么样？就我们是随便聊天说，结果呢。 您这个双年展那个半年前呢，就突然报了说我们要做了，那我就这样，我们就六个策展人联合策划一个外语展，是有澳大利亚的、有中国的、日本的、韩国的，合作做六个，那我是其中一个。
Since 2004, we visited China more often than before. So the first city we visited is Shanghai. Shanghai is more internationally than in Beijing. So we visited lots of galleries and artists. We started to talk to some friends, hey, let's do something between China and Southeast Asia. We said, okay, so just talk. And then in the end of the 2005, friends sent an email to us, hey, let's start the event. So 2006, we organized six curators, organized an exhibition called Satellite. At the same time with the Shanghai Biennale, because the Shanghai Biennale is the most famous Biennale in Shanghai, in China, but it's a government-based Biennale. It started to have some contemporary art, but later it's more and more not so independent. So we did the independent art is called Satellite. At the same time, have some curators from Australia, New Zealand, Korea, Japan, and Taiwan and China.
这就是展览现场。
That's the Creative Shanghai. It's a very old factory of GE, General Electric. Yeah, in
2020s.
About 30 artists get together. That's the Australian artist Richard Thomas.
Yeah. 这个展览当时轰动了上海，这个。So
the exhibition was very successful. At the opening, is about 1,000 of people they come for the opening.
很多艺术家呢，通过这个展览之后呢，就著名了，声量就特别高。So
many Chinese artists they became famous through this exhibition.
这个就是今年一个废弃的厂房。It's
like the old factory, the workshop.
上海的这个厂房比较多，空间都可以用。In
Shanghai, lots of old factories during the 1940s, 30s, so very many old factories.
2006年呢，就是那个泰国国家美术馆呢，希望就说，因为他们对中国也不太了解，因为希望我做一个这个独立策展人来策划一个美术馆跟美术馆一个交流的展览，当代艺术为主。那么我实际上是视频之外，我是这个独立策展人，那么我就帮他们联系广东美术馆，然后泰国想跟中国接轨嘛，那么广东美术馆呢是。 在中国体制当中，美术馆是最好的，一个美术馆，也是做当代艺术。
And 2006, the director of the National Gallery of Thailand, Tan Thai Glass, because we are very good friends, he said the Thai National Gallery of Thailand never export Thai artworks to China or the other countries. So can we organize or contact somebody in the Chinese art field to organize an exhibition? So we found the Guangdong Museum. Guangdong Museum is in Guangzhou, it's the south of China. It's a very open government museum. They collected a lot of artworks from different countries. So we contact the Guangdong Museum, so they make an exchange program between the National Gallery of Thailand and Guangdong Museum of China. But mostly he work for the fashion magazines, but we thought his work is quite match the topic, so we choose his work. And this artist, he is a singer, a star.
他通过这展览也出名了，这个做艺术家的画画。那个2010年的那个泰国呢，就是以阿密为主的那么一群当代艺术家呢，就是来做我宋庄，参加做我宋庄艺术节。 那么也是我们来邀请他们来做展览的，哎，他们是第一次到北京、苏州来做展览。So
2009, we both of us moved to China from Bangkok, and we set up our studio in Songjiang. It's a suburb of China, Beijing. And this is called the largest art village in the world. About 5,000 artists they live together in our village, 5,000. So, and related, I have the assistants and their families, all the art supplies. Normally, I think maybe more than 30,000 people they live together, all artists. So every year they have the art festival.
中国呢，北京呢是分几个艺术区，宋庄也是最大的。
Yeah. Beijing have some art artist village. So I One is very close to 798. I'm not sure if you heard 798. 798 Asun is has a very old factory, but lots of galleries there. Maybe at least 50 galleries. They are in the same area. So, but Songjiang is like a Zhejiang. I think Songjiang is quite similar with Zhejiang. So mostly the artists live there.
还有那个七大艺术区黑桥，年轻的都大概1000左右。
And the largest artist village is Songjiang, about 5,000. And the other is very close to 798. It's about 1,000 artists, but mostly young artists. Because the condition is not so good, very cold in the winter, so the rent fee is cheaper. So many young artists live there, about 1,000, very close to 798. So I think maybe in Beijing, around the
北京的宋庄艺术家呢，做当代的主要是在黑桥，在环体。宋庄艺术家呢，就是说跟当代艺术家，大概宋庄也是不到1000人吧。但是在宋庄现在都是非常有名的艺术家。
I think maybe 3000 contemporary artists. They live in Beijing, 3,000.
像一些市场明星啊，方力钧啊，什么王兴伟，什么都是在宋庄，岳云鹏是吧？So
this is the art festival, in Songjiang, the opening.
这个艺术家来做，宋庄每年都有一次艺术节。
So every year in September. Songjiang, they hold an art festival. So in 2009, they think they, 2010, they went to do an international art festival. So that's why we call to, we discuss with the organizer. So we invite the artists from Singapore and Thailand to join the event. So this team are from Thailand.
就在宋庄上上美术馆做的展。
And work installations, videos. This is our studio, so they visited our studio.
有西，这东南亚、新加坡的。
Three Singapore artists and nine Thai artists.
还有一些国外艺术家，那么来到我们去玩啊。在。 在讲座，在宋庄美术馆讲座，是除了上海美术馆的另外一个美术馆。
So we had a talk of a Thai contemporary art in a village museum. So in China, they have a different grade of museum, but this is a village museum. It's belong to the government as well. So we did a talk. It's called contemporary art from Thailand, because in China, not so many people they think. Southeast Asia have contemporary art. Southeast Asia, in their mind, is a very like countryside. It's a tourist area. So, so the two curators from Thailand, they are the curators for the Venice Biennale. So we talk about the contemporary art in Venice for the Chinese audience.
这也是他们那个宋庄的艺术家们来了很多，当时我们觉得挺意外，因为他们也想了解了解，因为他们跟东南亚的接触并不多。So
mostly Chinese artists they contact the art field in Europe or America, so very few chance to contact the art in Southeast
Asia。对，因为中国艺术家也是跟欧美比较靠近，那么就是，所以我们就。 就是让他们来了解了解这个东南亚，特别是泰国这些艺术生态，都非常有兴趣，在讲座。
So they're after them, they're very interested in the art in ASEAN. So maybe next time we will talk about the art from Indonesia. So in 2011, we organized an exhibition in the Bangkok Art and Culture Center. We want to invite the all ASEAN artists, but it depends on the funds. So only have three countries, China, Singapore, and Thailand. Three countries artists that we get together.
参加又加大概三个。
About more than 30 artists will get together.
主要有影像装置、其位、画什么的都要全了，大概一组人自己站。So
that's the performance from the Chinese artist. So his performance is sing the national song with a in the red. So we invited 100 of capitalists. So all the rich, all the big factory owners, capitalists, they sing the communist song. So that's the performance in the BACC, Bangkok Art and Culture Center. Very good artist from Thailand, Amri. So next time maybe I will let him come to Jakarta.
那这个做完席位之后呢，他们就把衣服放那里作为装置了啊，影像装置。That's
the installation of Chinese artists.
这组织很快，这也是一个泰国老艺术家在做的啊，影像装置。Thai
artist work.
这个就是我做的作品，That's
his work.
这个年轻艺术家做的，这也是年轻艺术家做的，这个道具，就做他的照片像，不是他的身世啊，家族啊。这个新加坡啊，这个新加坡就是
work Jason Lee，
就专门用包装盒在做。
That's Jason Lee. That afternoon we have artist talk, but Jason Lee did the performance outside the audience.
这个呢，就是一个那个泰文的东盟，那个主要是给做东盟，一个电视一个专题节目，那么。 他对我们的橄榄非常有兴趣，请我去做这个嘉宾，来那个讲我们的橄榄情况。So
that's ASEAN TV. They have an English program in Thailand, so they invite us to have a talk on their program, ASEAN Talks.
这个呢，就是说那个，这是在2011年9月份做的，就是广东三年展，中国最重要的展览。那么，这也是国家来请，因为对东亚的大艺术了解的人不多，只有我，因为我在东南亚，那么他自然就找到我，那个馆长就找，希望我们做这个展览，他坐飞机来到北京，从广州在北京来找我，那么做这个展览。
This project, we made it after we visit Thailand and after the exhibition in Thailand. We suggest to Guangzhou Biennale in Guangdong Museum, 2011, because they have a chance to invite the artists from ASEAN, but they only give us 3 months to prepare the exhibition. So it's a very rush, so work very hard. It's the largest event for the ASEAN plus China exhibition in China.
那个主要三层全都给我们做了，大概2000多平方米吧。That's
the opening of the exhibition.
这就是一个开幕式，就开始开幕式，就这本画册。
That's the catalog from the exhibition.
Allow the performance art because they scared, they cannot control it. But we request performance art. We promise nothing happened. So that day we have performance.
在缅甸那个来的艺术家，他们在
These are artists from Burma. So we have volunteers from the university to help them. My colleague from Singapore. This artist is from Thailand, so we shipped all the roof tops and everything materials from Thailand to Guangzhou to build a Thai house. Because his work is how is the farmer's the farm boy to the big capitals, how to survive in the big capitals. All the materials are shipped from Thailand.
越南艺术家就是一个小学生。So
this is a work from a Vietnamese artist. The title is High School Students.
所以就是他们电视台来做这个广东电台来做采访这个艺术家，就展览，因为这个东亚作为挺有特点，那么这个从北京来的还有广东的是媒体呢，就比较有兴趣。So
we imagine some TV channel to have an interview with the artists from Southeast Asia because Guangdong is a very important province like Hokkien, Canton. So lots of overseas Chinese are from Canton and Hokkien. So the Guangdong TV channel, they're very interested about art from ASEAN countries. So they did an interview with our artists.
因为呢，这次比较全面的将东南亚来做到中国来展示，就比较多。文化部还有什么无论是体制还是独立的，很多这个做当代艺术的都过来看，他们好一天是4万人，总共4万人。So
the exhibition have a 40,000 audience to visit the exhibition, and mostly the newspapers, they think it's very fresh, the art from Southeast Asia.
这次展览呢，做的因为他们那个就觉得东亚这个政面貌这么奇奇学来过展览，那么大家都很有兴趣，同时呢，这个广东美术馆呢，因为他们是收藏一个机构，是在屏障中是最健全的，所以东南亚很多作品它都收藏了，包括有一个印尼的这些作品全部收藏了。So
have a Singapore artist, they interviewed a Singapore artist. And Guangdong Museum, their collection is the biggest collection in China. So every time if they have a international exhibition there, so they will collect the artworks. So they collect the individuals and the heritage installation. Mostly are installations. That's artist from Philippines. Mark's our us.
做监狱啊，做。
They also collected this set of the sculptures from Vietnam. This work is from Vietnam, Richard Tien. The reason he sent the photograph because he has a proposal to make turtles in South China Sea. So the proposal had didn't pass by the censorship, so he changed the work. That's Harry's work. The video installations from your mom. This artist is very famous in Thailand, Kami.
就是安利做这个做这个水水城啊，做这个做完之后呢，这回去不久就派我发水了。This
work is by Thai artist Water City. So after that, Thai suffered a flood in Bangkok.
这个是新加坡一个那个艺术家做的行为，这次也是。
So this is from Singapore. Andrew Wester, she's French, living in Singapore, so did a performance.
This is Jimmy, also my friend. He's doing the
behavior.
His house is called Jin House.
This is the Singapore artist Jeremy Hai. He did a performance as well on the opening.
就刚才那个搭那房子啊。So
that's the farmhouse from Thailand.
房子里面有他的故事，还有影像，就是在一个酒吧，他在酒吧也。So
that's the video and photograph of the artist. Tell the story how he survived in Bangkok.
2011年的那个11月份呢，就我们中国几个艺术家，那么就说去新加坡，一个机构，一个空间，把这个去做展览，改变掉。So
after that we did change China and Singapore art exhibition in the substation in Singapore.
这个就是这个金庸的展览，那么他的展览就在讲课，他主要是在现场讲他做艺术的道理，怎么去做艺术，艺术是为了什么，就是在现场给大家讲课，当然来很多人，那么就是他对整个把照片贴在墙上。That's
a Chinese artist work, and also he did a talk on the opening. And for the talk, we paid about $22 for the permission from the police station.
Only for 24
hours. And this artist, his work is about a bubble. Because economy like a bubble, art market is like a bubble. So we did a performance in the opening.
It's a collaborative work, everyone can blow. So he blows the best.
So finally we had a prize because who did the best job, so the artist gave a one photograph to the audience.
These 艺术家都是参加过世界重要展览，什么双年展啊，什么都去了，都用过。So
he's the one did the performance, the sing the national song in Thailand.
现场啊，大家都在处理啊。
Just the opening.
这是我们预定的。
No, that's his work.
这个呢，就是这个新加坡呢，来在中国做一个做展览，就是新加坡一个机构玉家村。也是搞当代艺术的，就是一个做这个当代艺术的机构。那么在苍染地做一个展览，叫生活展览啊，与中国艺术家一块做的。
This exhibition Survival, is four Singaporean artists. They come to Beijing. The artists are from the artist village of Singapore.Because we think survival is a very serious thing for artists independent. But we think Indonesia is much better than the other countries because Indonesia have a lot of collectors.
Because 在草场地呢，就草场地呢也是一个艺术家村，但是离去巴比较近。那么艾薇尔就在，这是艾薇尔做的啊，做的一个。他做出的事情，后来慢慢大家都去了。以后呢，经济发展之后，他就很多画廊进去了，就是创意。
So this is the space in China, designed by Ai Weiwei. I think maybe you know Ai Weiwei. So Ai Weiwei, he designed this style of buildings to rent to the artists for studios.It's very close to 798, the gallery space. But later, more and more foreign galleries, they entered this area. So artists came out because the rent fee is higher and higher. So artists, they can't afford it. So became another gallery space. So we did the survival exhibition in one of the gallery. It's different kind of a method for the different artists, but his family is quite rich, so they have a lot of restaurants, and so he never have problem with survival, to lack of money, but he has a very special survival thing is he opened a post museum, a museum, and one of the project is soup kitchen.Because a lot of foreign laborers from India and Bangladesh in Singapore, so they haven't had space to cook by themselves. So he opened a soup kitchen on Saturday and Sunday to let the laborers to come and cook in his kitchen. So that's the way of survival of the rich guys.
就是在做这个，在装饰它。
And this is Benpua. Benpua, his way of survival is teach the art in the social community.
他主要在社区做。
And to the kids and to the elders in Singapore.
这后面那个是我一个朋友在中国的，他是那个原来是在北京做当代艺术挺有影响的，后来他就回到家里去，回到他们村里去做村长了。
So at the back,
叫金乐，叫现在叫
村长。That artist is a Chinese artist. He was a sculptor in living in Beijing, but after the economic crisis, he cannot afford for the his living cost in Beijing. He moved back to countryside.So became a village elder, so live in the village. So his way of survival is live in the village, back to the countryside.
他把那个他们村里的胡椒，还有那个庄稼地里的石头，还有土泥拿来做。
So all the materials is peppers from his countryside. So the smell is very strong in the exhibition.
就意思叫中国的山水画，就是中国山水。
So that's the new landscape of the Chinese new landscape. So that's the new landscape, the peppers.
这也是一个新加坡的一个艺术家金金勇，他在做行为。And
that's Jeremy Hire. He opens a non-profit exhibition space for the young Singaporean artist. It's called Your Mother Gallery. Because in Singapore, many young artists, they have not opportunity to show their work in the very high rental spaces. So Jeremy opened the guest room in his apartment and called it Your Mother Gallery, so everybody can exhibit the work in his gallery.
In Your Mother Gallery.
Your Mother Gallery. Yeah, you can visit his gallery in Little India if you go to Singapore.
就是在那个现场的时候。So
he did a performance at the opening.
这个是我在帮他忙，我们一起在做的领导啊，做什么的，都是在。And
he bought the material in China. The opening day. There are two floors of the exhibition. The new landscape.
这是一个新加坡艺术家，做行为艺术家叫开，做。And
that's Kai Lam. He's a performance artist from Singapore. That's
Kuntian
Whisper.
Because
we live in Thailand more than 20 years, so we think we have a duty to introduce the art from ASEAN to China, to push the art from ASEAN to China. But actually, he said he's an artist, so maybe he's an artist, and the other side, he wants to do his best to promote art from ASEAN.
你说做你想做策展，做到你想，现在有很多人还要找我，说我现在做艺术家了，我说我这两年主要在做作品，三四年。
The curators is a very hard work because you should find the money, you should negotiate with the galleries, and you should find a good artist. So it's a very hard work.
主要是在做作品的这几年，主要在做装置影像行为。 那么就是这个，这是只是跟大家汇报，跟大家讲一下这个我们周围这个东亚与中国这种生态，更多的是希望大家以后到来能看我的作品，我的展览。
He said this is the introduction that we work for the China and ASEAN artists, but. Actually, maybe he's an artist, so you're welcome to join his opening at 16 September 16 in London Art Foundation, his solo show.
主要是对那个艺术影像，就是这个艺术的地方也不太了解，这次主要来玩一玩，跟大家交朋友，也顺便做点东西。
And this is the first time we visit Jogja, so. We want to make friends with everybody, and maybe later we have more chance to do exhibitions between China and Indonesia.
We
like Jogja very much.
And got a lot of inspirations here.
希望你有什么,
if you have questions and suggestions, comment, you can ask me freely.
Thank you, Margaret, for the presentation. Jadi kalau boleh mengkonklusi dan mungkin sedikit mereka sebanyak kali juga dari penyampaian dari Kexin tadi saya mencatat beberapa hal sih. Kalau saya melihat secara umum praktik karena tadi si Kexin menjelaskan tentang praktik kuratorial dia. Kalau saya melihat ada kecenderungan dari Kexin untuk mempromosikan seni rupa kontemporer Asia Tenggara ke Cina. Dan itu seperti yang dia bilang tadi, dikarenakan di Cina sendiri itu masih sedikit orang yang mengetahui atau kenal dengan praktek-praktek seni rupa kontemporer yang dilakukan di Asia Tenggara. Dan Kexin sendiri juga mengajar di Thailand dan subjek yang diajarkan adalah seni rupa kontemporer Asia Tenggara. Kemudian yang menarik juga karena tinggal di Cina, Kexin punya kecenderungan untuk melakukan negosiasi dengan pemerintah. Baik dalam pelaksanaan pameran atau juga dalam bagaimana khususnya dalam pelaksanaan pameran dan untuk negosiasi dengan musuh tempat diadakannya pameran tersebut. Kayaknya itu sih kalau dari saya, mungkin dari teman-teman yang hadir, jika ada yang ingin ditanyakan, ada komentar atau apapun yang mau disampaikan, dibagi, silakan. Dan seperti yang tadi Mbak Melisa bilang, kalau ada yang ada kesusahan untuk berbahasa Indonesia, berbahasa Inggris, bisa disampaikan dalam bahasa Indonesia, nanti akan saya bantu menggunakan. Mau silakan? Ada yang mau bertanya? Untuk komentar? Jadi mungkin nanti mau menyampaikan sesuatu.
Mungkin saya bisa kasih sedikit pengantar kenapa kemudian Kexin dan Margaret kita buatkan sesi di sini. Pertama karena kemudian mereka berkata bahwa mereka adalah dua orang pertama yang dari Cina yang kemudian ada inisiatif pribadi untuk kemudian datang ke Jogja. Jadi ini benar-benar yang independen, yang inisiatifnya berasal dari pribadinya. Jadi ketika Santi dan Miko Indi Gerilas ikut Guangzhou Triennale tahun what was the year? 2011, itu mereka bertemu dengan Kexin dan Margaret. Waktu itu Kexin jadi kuratornya. Terus mereka cerita tentang Jogja dan mereka tertarik. Mereka tertarik sekali, tapi kemudian dari Cina sendiri tidak ada infrastruktur yang mendukung untuk mereka bisa ke Jogja. Jadi mereka bekerja, terus mereka sudah pengen datang ke Jogja, kirim proposal, mencari funding dan sebagainya untuk datang ke Jogja itu dari tahun itu. Jadi baru tahun ini mereka bisa ke Jogja, lalu untuk tinggal residensinya di support oleh London Art Foundation. Lalu mereka ingin memanfaatkan kesempatan pertama ini untuk benar-benar kenal dengan art scene di Jogja. Jadi pertama kali yang mereka tanyakan, di Jogja ini senimannya ada berapa? Saya tidak bisa menjawab, Indi Gerilas tidak bisa menjawab. Ketika ngobrol dengan dari Langgeng, tidak bisa menjawab. Kita ke tempatnya beberapa seniman, tidak bisa jawab. Bahkan kemudian hari ini ketemu sama Santi, ketika ditanya berapa seniman ada di Jogja, tidak pernah ada hitungan pasti. Sementara untuk mereka, itu ini berkenaan dengan survival ya, bertahan hidup, jadi harus tahu pesaingnya ada berapa, siapa yang bisa diajak kerjasama dan sebagainya. Nah untuk mereka, Jogja ini istimewa karena kayaknya semua orang terbuka, bisa ngobrol, menerima orang baru. Mereka bertemu dengan banyak seniman asing yang kemudian datang dan kemudian tinggal di sini, itu juga diterima dengan tangan terbuka. Sementara ketika pertama kali Kexin keluar dari Cina, dari Harbin, di tahun, what was the year when Kexin left China then to Russia?
1991.
Di tahun 91, itu situasinya memang tidak ideal gitu. Jadi untuk bertahan hidup, itu dia menjual karyanya di jalan. dari konsep di Cina, seniman buat karya untuk pemerintah, terus hidup terjamin. Ketika kemudian nyantol di Rusia, dia mulai karya ini dibuat untuk hidup. Setelah kemudian pindah ke Thailand, lalu bekerja sama dengan seniman-seniman dari Singapura dan sebagainya, mereka lihat bahwa untuk hidup dalam seni rupa itu susah. Jadi seniman itu susah, bahkan dia cerita untuk jadi kurator itu juga susah. Harus bikin koneksi dengan galeri, harus cari seniman yang bagus dan sebagainya, selalu susah. Sementara dia lihat di sini, ini sepertinya dinamikanya berbeda. Nah, mungkin ada teman-teman di sini yang bisa membagi cerita. Mungkin Mbak Francisca mau sedikit berbagi karena dari Jerman datang ke Jogja. Apakah ada persamaan, apakah ada perbedaan, apakah ada kemungkinan untuk di masa depan bekerja sama? Terus ada Mbak Mira ini yang kurator. Mira is a young curator. She also start her own art space. And then the husband is also an artist, photographer. So mungkin bisa sedikit berbagi cerita. Teman-teman yang lain yang mungkin baru mengenali tentang seni rupa dan sebagainya, kalau ada pertanyaan apa-apa, monggo. Mbak, ada juga boleh berbagi. Ada Denny di belakang. Ini seniman, he's a graphic artist. He's also part of a collective, graphic collective called Grafis Minggiran. He's also a lecturer, but not in Jogja, but in Solo. So, sharing dan sharing. Because sharing is caring. Yeah. So, mungkin this is the chance for everyone to get to know each other, to explore the possibility. Mungkin bisa jadi apa, open-ended. Ada Amin dari Afghanistan. So yeah, ini kesempatannya terbuka. Tapi sebelumnya, beforehand, because everyone is so tense, ada minuman dan makanan, silakan diambil dulu. Nanti kita ngobrol nyantai. Silakan, silakan. Mbak.
Makan.
You understand? Oh, good. Mbak Francisca. The microphone.
Yes, thank you for the chance for sharing. I came to Universitas Persia Jogja first time in 2007, and I was very surprised and very deeply impressed from the art scene, and I felt like directly. Something I have to be longer. And then when my way had to take me home for 4 years, and I also said I found my husband here. And then when I was back in Germany, I always wanted to get back to Indonesia or get back to Asia. And then we founded the art association, German Asian Art Association, made projects here in Jogja and in Jakarta. The first was Dystopia, so we brought certain Indonesian artists to Denny was also in Jogja. So we brought them to Dresden and to Berlin and to Museum. And then next year we went on with German artists here. But then I felt, okay, that's okay, I just got some projects, always come here, and then so certain also went to China, to Shanghai. But then I still felt, oh, I want to be really here. And then 2013, yeah, I was looking for projects, so that you have to a nice center, and then went to Bandung. So this was the first time that I can also really experience Bandung for 2 months. Very different art scene there, went to Georgia, but also very, very interesting. Made a project in a space outside in the Lebanon Mountain. And then came to Georgia, and then of course comes the question of survival. Okay, next, try to find an institution. And then made a project with Goethe Institute. And, yeah, now I think we're ready again to keep on with this cover event, German Asian Art Association. We made 2 years like a complete break.
Yeah, but I can say that being here and interact with the artists is for me is a very, very, it's very inspiring. It's very how to come into to exchange ideas. It's, also to work big. It's really very interesting. But I personally think that in future it's also much more interesting in bigger Asia, just to be in bigger Asia and not to sit around in old Europe.
Margaret, do you need to translate to Kesin? Do you want to sit closer?
He said that he thinks there are three places for the contemporary art in the world is very important. One is Berlin. The second in Asia is Beijing. The third is Georgia.
Wow. 你说我们去亚洲去了很多地方，包括印度我也待了两年，印度，但印度呢，它还是没有主要本土，没有特别。Yeah,
can completely understand about Georgia. It's also you have to be here in June when it's the art shop time. It's like everywhere's popping up exhibitions and like everybody really is like every post box even gets an exhibition place. It's really, really cool time. And
another question. Because Boris just now said that in 2011 you planned to come here but didn't happen and then it took 4 years, so then now in 2015 you finally reached Georgia. So my question is, how do you feel that, visiting galleries and artists and so on, do you feel that you have lost this time in the sense that most of the artists have been exhibited in Beijing and Shanghai? I mean, is this scene is really high, you know, and then you come now and you plan to, so my question is, what are your plans actually to do after your visit in Georgia and how you want to involve this art scene of Yogyakarta in your project of Asian art, Southeast Asian art in China?
Also, what kind of artists are you searching, and what kind of projects you plan? 你说主要是呢，这次来主要是真是没有办什么想法来的，主要是说，实际上就对这个印度一下一直很有兴趣，因为我很多朋友都在这儿，而且这个家家庭我很喜欢。 觉得很新奇，就是说当地的人，无论是什么民族啊，无论什么种族，都很喜欢艺术。你看，想要涂鸦什么，到处就是从骨子里喜欢艺术。我觉得这个土壤倒是值得，就是感觉就是跟他们一样，就是这个地方还是有意思的活力，还会有发展。
Before we come, many people, friends, they are doing business in Indonesia. So everybody told me that the custom here is very strict. So we brought a roll of painting in our suitcase. So I was scared and see the form, the custom declare form. So how much money you bring, all things they should declare. So I have a little bit scared. So I met a lecturer from Thailand. He has a program in EC. So he's a musician. He told me, no problem, because Jaksha, if the custom they check their paintings in your suitcase, they have never had problem. But he brought a banana from Thailand, that's the problem. And then...
And then...
Because we're talking about art. He said he found that the first impression is we go everywhere, we found that the people here like art and culture, full of culture and art. Even the citizens or ordinary people, that's the art field, not in the art field. And we found the second thing is it's very quite similar with the Chinese art field and the Indonesian art
field.
Before we come, so all the artists told us about the art market in Indonesia. Because before, in I think maybe 1990s, started from 1990s, big collectors, a group of big collectors in Indonesia, they collected Chinese art. And they pushed the Chinese art to the market, so the prices are very high. And then the Europeans, they bought from the Indonesian. So all the news we found heard is Indonesian art market and collectors, but not for artists. But when we arrived here, we found that the artists are very active. All the recent make a program to visit the different art space. Even the young artists, they have their own space to collect art. And so we think it's very active.
主要是艺术家也很像，市场化之后呢，就是艺术家都有钱了，就是像你，我要是真实梦想，就是盖大公司，这公司是盖的很大很豪华，你就是跟在美国比中国还要厉害，就是。And
the other thing is very similar is if the artists are very famous and they rich, they build a huge house for their studio.
是美国呀，是美国的梦想。It's
very similar in China. And by cars.
你说很像，你说，那么就说艺术家入市场之后呢，就说，买房子、买车呀，然后扩巩固自己的一个商业网络啊，是这样。基本，年轻艺术家跟中国也很像，有很多人也在吸。现在市场的就是高的很高，艺术家有了钱之后的话，做的都很大，很行。但很多年轻人还有些探索型艺术家呢。 并不在乎，还是在能够有饭吃之下，还在坚持做。And
we think is the second thing is the famous artists like China, they have their market very stable in market, and the young artists they are very active in their project. But the artists in the middle range are quite difficult, like in China, because the market is the collectors not care about their art, and the universities or the some collectors, they are looking for the young artists, but they don't care about the middle-aged artists. So we think maybe it's the same problem with the in Indonesian art scene. I'm not sure. It's the same. But we think maybe finally, we'll go to the commercial way, like China.
Because当代艺术这一块呢，主要是体制外面比较独立的这边呢，也有，他这里出没有机会以外，他必须要卖自己作品进入这个市场。那么这市场呢，如果好的话，当代艺术还要发展，实际他们是很火的。 那不像体制的，因为体制的我们也记住，中国体制跟专制体制是一样的啊，是两个概念。更多的我关注是独立的在这一块。
But in China, many artists they have their government job, like lecturers, professors in the universities and some institutes. But they never pay tax when they sell their own works. So, but we are talking about we care about more independent artists. So they should fight with the market. So very hard. So the work should be matched for the market. So we really understand. They cannot do the very conceptual things the market cannot accept. So sometimes their work should to go in the market way. So we really understand. So we think China and Indonesia has the same.
Like the exact number of how many artists living in an area.
头一次从别人到是艺术家是吧？那就在中国能够在宋庄就能体验出来，就是宋庄因为出了很多那个明星嘛，像画什么一百万啊，什么一千万的，很多农民呢，还有这个开小店啊什么的，一听艺术家都很羡慕，就说我也想做艺术家。有很多呢，就是说那个农民也画画，出租车司机也画画，那他们就觉得是误区，觉得是画画就应该赚钱，但他们确实喜欢这种东西。我认为呢，他可能也算是艺术家，这种概念是混淆的。
It's very hard to say because I will a bit introduce the place we live in art village, because in 1990s, in China before, everybody should live in their own province. They have a register of their ID card. So if you born in Jakarta, so you should live in Jakarta. You cannot move to Jakarta. So otherwise you have a job in Jakarta. So the government don't allow the independent people have no job, and traveling is impossible in 1990s, before 1990s. So from 1990s, a group of young people, they come to Beijing. So sometimes, some of them, they are graduated students. So they have a very free things, very, they want to be like a Western style to live in Beijing and do the works they like. So sometimes they are students from art school, or some people they want to entrance to the to pass the entrance to the universities in Beijing. So they live in outside Beijing is a very small village. So many people they live there. But finally, the Western embassies, they found this group of people, the American embassy or the European embassy. So they start to support this group of young people, because they found that they were anti the government. So they need to support them to anti Chinese government. So they start to buy the paintings, and they start to support them to have exhibition in the embassies. So the freelance artists happened in 1990s because of the support from the foreign embassies. And after that, because the village they live is quite close to some very important palace, so then the police come in, they let the people let people go up to their own countryside. But finally, they move to Songzhuang. It's very far from the city, about 30 kilometers from Tiananmen Square. So it was a very poor village. So the farmhouse is very small, but the farmers, they are going to the city to have a work. So there are a lot of empty house, farmhouse, very poor and old, no road in this in the village, and a lot of sands there. So the winds and with the sands coming, so very poor. But the elder of the village, they thought maybe it's a way, kind of way to rent the house to the artists, so the villagers, they can get the income. So that's why maybe 100 of artists, they moved to the village. They moved to the village, but they don't allow to do any strange things, because you wear their clothes, you could not shout in the evening, and you could not sing in the evening because everybody is sleeping. And then after that, more and more people coming to the village. So maybe later, 1,000 artists, they live there, they get together. So the market star happened in the village. A lot of Indonesian clients, the collectors, they go straight to the village and buy the works from the artists. So some of the artists are getting rich. Then the farmers think, why? They just paint and painting, they can sell a million yuan. So the whole year income of mine is only 1,000. Why could I be an artist?
So they learn to paint. So, and the taxi drivers, the farmers, they all paint. So very strange thing is the group of Thai artists, they visited the art festival in 2010. So when we have a talk in the village museum, and they think that they thought, okay, the summer have a question, so what do you think about the Jakarta, what do you think about Sunton? The professor said, yes, I was very impressed by this place, because in the morning, in the market, I want to find something to eat, but everybody sold paintings on the ground. So, I don't know how to count who is the artist. Yeah, maybe later, more and more government-based artists, they come, like the university professors, they have job in their province, universities, but after the, in the summer vacation or summer holidays, the school term is over, so they fly to Beijing and work in the studio. So we have kind of this kind of artist. And the other thing is the government police station, they come to every artist's home, so we should fill up the form. So that's why they control the amount of the artists.
Ada lagi yang mau bertanya? Jam 7 ada pembukaan Kexin di London Exhibition.